is. Arun is 2 years older than Bharat. Okay, Arun is 2 years older than Bharat, who is twice as old as Charit. Okay, so here what I will do, I will take equation. Arun is 2 years older than Bharat. Okay, this is first thing, first equation. Continuation of the same sentence. Who is means Bharat is twice as old as Charit. Twice as old as Charit. Okay, from first sentence I got two equations. If the total ages of Arun, Bharat and Charit. Okay, Arun, Bharat and Charit, total age is 27. Okay, this is third equation I am getting. How old is Bharat? So B value we have to find out. B value we have to find out. Okay, so what we will do, I will use 2 in 3. Okay, using 2 in 3. So equation 3, okay, I will put C is nothing but B by 2. So A plus B plus, in the place of C, I am putting B by 2. Okay, which is from equation 2. In equation 3, in the place of C, I am putting B by 2, which I got from equation 2. So using 2 in 3, this is equal to 27. Okay, so we are getting A plus 3 by 2 B is nothing but 27. This is equation 3A because we got it from equation 3. We got it from equation 3. I am naming it as 3A. Now first equation I will take. So A minus B is nothing but 2. I have modified the equation. This is equation number 1. Okay, this is equation number 1. Just slightly I have modified. Okay, B I have taken to the LHS. So A minus B equal to 2. Okay, so now subtract this. What will happen? On subtraction, these two will get cancelled. 3 by 2 minus of minus, okay, will become 5 by 2 b is nothing but on subtraction it is 25. 5 will get cancelled, so half b equal to 5, so b value equal to 10 years. Okay, so directly what they are asking, you try to convert all other equations in terms of b in order to find the value of b. Okay, so I will stop with this question. From problems on ages, I will go to the next problem. So Tanya's grandfather was 8 times older to her 16 years ago. Okay, it is a story of 16 years ago. Tanya's grandfather was 8 times older to her. Okay, so what I will do, grandfather 16 years ago, okay, he is 8 times older than Tanya's age, which is 16 years ago. Okay, this is equation 1. First sentence I am writing like this. 16 years ago means present age we will take grandfather age G and Tanya age T, which is at present. Okay, 16 years ago means G minus 16, T minus 16. So 16 years ago, grandfather age is 8 times older than Tanya's age. This is equation 1. He would be 3 times her age 8 years from now. From now means future. Okay, so 8 years from now, grandfather will become G plus 8, Tanya will become T plus 8, okay, which is 8 years from now, and their age will be 3 times. Grandfather age will be 3 times Tanya's age. Okay, this is our second equation. Next sentence, 8 years ago, okay, and this is 8 years from now. So future, equation 2 we completed. Now next sentence is 8 years ago. What was the ratio of Tanya's age to that of grandfather's age? Okay, so what we are supposed to find, 8 years ago means they are asking Tanya's age to that of grandfather's age. So Tanya's age 8 years ago and then grandfather's age 8 years ago, what is the ratio? This we have to find. Okay, so first of all, from 1 and 2 equations, from equation 1 and 2, we will try to get the values of G and T. From equation 1, G minus 8T is nothing but 16 minus 16 8s are. 128 is okay? 128. Is it okay? G minus 8T equal to 16 8s are. So 8 6 are 48. 4 12 correct. 16 plus 16 minus 128. So g minus 8t. If you subtract 16, what will happen? Minus 112. Okay, minus 112. This is our equation 1a. This is our equation 1a. Now coming to from equation 2, I can write g minus 3t equal to minus 8 plus 24. This is from equation 2 I am writing. This is from equation 2 I am writing g minus 3t equal to minus 8 plus 24. So g minus 3t equal to, so this becomes plus 16. Okay, this be equation 2a. Now solve 1a and 2a. Now solve 1a and 2a. G minus 3t equal to plus 16. If you subtract, this 2 will get cancelled. If you subtract, this will become minus 5t. Okay, and if you subtract, this will become minus 128 again. And t value, it is a fraction. It is not exactly divisible by 5. It is not exactly divisible by 5. So t is nothing but 2 times and then 5 times 0.6. This is Tanya's age. Okay. Now put this in any of the equations. I am going to use it in equation 2a. If I use it in equation 2a, g minus, okay, 3 times 25.6 equal to 16. Equal to 16. Okay. Now what will happen? G minus 18.1. 16 1 7 okay equal to 16. G value is nothing but 16 means 92.8. So now here this ratio will become 25.6 minus 8 divided by 92.8 minus 8. Okay, so maybe because I have taken from internet. Okay, so the ratios I also have one more option, none of this. If my answer is not there in the options, I can choose none of this also. Okay, sometimes like that. So we have to do appropriately. And here after simplification, if I subtract 8, this becomes 17.6. If I subtract 8, this will become 84.8. Okay, on simplification, it will get cancelled with 4. So 4 4s are and 4 4s are 2 1 2. Okay. Again with 4 if I cancel, 1.1, and here if I cancel with 4, it becomes 5 times 0.3. Multiply with 10, this is 11 by 53. Ratio I am getting 11 is to 53. Tanya and the grandfather's age 8 years ago, ratio is 11 by 53. Okay, if it is 55 in the denominator, if it is 55 in the denominator, I will get 1 is to 5, which is option B. But presently I am getting option D as my answer. Kindly try along with me. If you are getting different answers, stop me or post in the chat box. We will look at it. Okay, only options. If you are getting other than 11 by 53, okay, none of this other than my answer, kindly you can speak out. Otherwise, post your answer in the chat box. So according to my simplification, I got 11 by 53. I'm going to the next problem. Age of father 10 years ago was thrice the age of his son. Okay, 10 years ago. So father minus 10 and the son minus 10. 10 years ago, father age equal to thrice the age of son. Father age equal to thrice the age of son. Okay, sentence as it is, I have put it as equation. 10 years hence means from now. Okay, 10 years hence means from now. 10 years from now. Son also will become 10 years from now. Father's age is twice the age of his son. Father's age is twice the age of his son. Okay. The ratio of their present ages they are asking. Okay. If you see all the options, higher value, lower value is there. So it should be father divided by son ratio. What is the ratio? Okay. Ratio of their present ages. Solve it in order to get f value and s value. Okay, from first equation I am getting f minus 3s will be equal to plus 10 minus 30. So f minus 3s equal to minus 20. This is equation 1a because I got it from equation 1. From second equation, this is f minus 2s equal to minus 10 plus 20. Okay, minus 10 plus 20. And this is f minus 2a is equal to plus 10. This is equation 2a. Okay, if you solve it, f minus 2a is equal to plus 10. If you subtract, what will happen? First term will get cancelled. Okay, minus s. And then if you subtract, this side it will become minus 30. Okay, this will become, if you subtract, it will become minus 20, minus 10 will become minus 30. Minus 3s, minus of minus 2s will become minus s. So s value is 30. S value is 30. You put it in any equation. If I use it in this equation, f minus 2 into 30 will become 60. It is equal to 10. Father age is 70. Okay, this is present age we are getting. Present age we are getting 70 divided by 30. So it is 7 divided by 3. 7 is to 3 is our answer. 7 is to 3 is our answer. Okay.